Today, we hit the road and leave Cayo Coco for a day trip to the province of Ciego de Avila. We'll journey to the heart of Cuba to explore the vibrant culture, rich history, and unique way of life of this often misunderstood country. First things first, let's talk about how we're getting there. The causeway in Cuba, also known as La Autopista del Mar or the Marine Highway, is a remarkable feat of engineering that spans 48 kilometers across the Bay of Buena Vista in central Cuba.
We're gonna do a lot of activities today, so I'm going to show you, I have the pleasure of showing you my reality, Cuban reality, which is completely different to the reality of Cayo Coco or Cayo Coco.
This magnificent roadway links the island of Cayo Coco to the mainland city of Morón in Ciego de Avila province. The construction of the causeway began in 1989 and took 4 years to complete. The project was carried out by the Cuban government as part of an effort to boost tourism and economic development in the region. The cost of the construction has been estimated to be around $100 million. The causeway is an engineering marvel, consisting of a total of 46 bridges, some of which rise up to 65 feet above the water. The roadway is supported by 2,600 pillars, each one 65 feet deep, and it is 52 feet wide, making it one of the widest causeways in the world. The town of Morón is located in the northern part of the province of Ciego de Avila in central Cuba, and while it may not be as well known as some of the country's larger cities, it is nevertheless a vital hub of economic and cultural activity. To understand why Morón is so important to Cuba, we must first look at its history. The town was founded in 1543 and has been a center of agriculture and commerce for centuries. In the early 20th century, the town began to flourish thanks to the construction of the Central Highway, which linked it to other important cities in the country. In terms of culture, Morón is known for its rich Afro-Cuban heritage. The town is home to several important cultural institutions, including the Casa de la Cultura, which hosts a variety of events and performances throughout the year. The town is also famous for its carnival, which takes place every year in February and is a celebration of African and Cuban culture. Economically, Morón is important for its agriculture. The town is located in a fertile region of Cuba and is known for its production of sugar, citrus fruits, and tobacco. These crops are essential to the Cuban economy, and Morón's role as a transportation hub makes it easier to transport these goods to other parts of the country. Our first stop in Morón is the Crocodile Farm. Criadero de Cocodrilo. Here are some things you might want to know before you visit.
We don't know what's the sex of it yet. You know, until they are 6 years old. And the only one way of getting its sex is introducing your finger back there. Okay? And they know how to do it. You know, the sex of the crocodile depends on the weather. Temperature is over 30 degrees, they are male. If it's under 30 degrees, they are females. So in captivity, we can control.
This conservation and breeding farm is located 13 kilometers east of Morón and about 45 minutes drive from Cayo Coco. The farm belongs to the National Society for the Protection and Conservation of Flora and Fauna. The Crocodile Farm was founded in 1962, and it has been an important center for the conservation and study of Cuban crocodiles ever since. There are several different types of crocodiles that live in the farm, including the American crocodile and the Cuban crocodile. Visitors can learn all about these fascinating creatures and even hold a baby crocodile if they dare. The farm is not just a place to see crocodiles. This farm specializes in breeding American crocodiles, with over 800 on their 65-hectare estate. Visitors can learn about and interact with the crocodiles, even holding and feeding baby ones. There's also a ranchon-style restaurant on-site serving exotic dishes made with crocodile meat and other specialties. The Crocodile Farm in Cuba is a must-visit for anyone looking for a unique and exciting experience. You'll learn about the conservation efforts to protect this endangered species, and see these incredible predators up close. Don't forget to take home a souvenir of a crocodile teeth necklace. I'm now taking you on a horse wagon tour throughout Morón. Morón is a small city located in the central part of Cuba, and it's known for its beautiful landscapes, historic sites, and friendly people. If you're planning to visit Cuba and you're interested in exploring the countryside, then this horse wagon tour is a must-try experience. You'll get to see some of the most beautiful landscapes in Cuba. The tour will take you through the countryside, and you'll get to see some of the local farms and plantations, where you can learn about the different crops grown in the region, such as sugarcane, tobacco, and coffee. This is Hotel Morón, a timeless treasure built in the 1940s that has been delighting guests with its charm ever since. This elegant establishment has become a beloved landmark in the area, attracting visitors from far and wide who are drawn to its exquisite colonial architecture. With grand archways, high ceilings, and ornate details, this building is a masterpiece that evokes the glamour and sophistication of a bygone era. Host to a dazzling array of notable figures, including the legendary Fidel Castro himself. Morón is an essential part of the Cuban landscape. Its strategic location, transportation infrastructure, cultural heritage, and agricultural production make it a vital hub of economic and cultural activity. While the town faces many challenges, its people remain committed to ensuring that Morón continues to play an important role in Cuba's past, present, and future.
Patria o muerte, venceremos.
Homeland or death, we will prevail. The phrase was first introduced by Fidel Castro in a speech commemorating the workers and soldiers who lost their lives in the La CUBA explosion on March 5, 1960, at the harbor in Havana. Morón is a lesser-known town in Cuba, but it has a rich history and culture. Here are some interesting facts that many people may not know about Morón. The name Morón comes from a tree called the Moron, which used to be abundant in the area. The town is known for its unique architecture, which includes both colonial-style buildings and more modern structures. The town played an important role in the Cuban War of Independence, with many battles and skirmishes taking place in the area. Morón is a hub for transportation in central Cuba, with a major train station and several highways passing through the area. Cuba was a pioneer in railway construction in 1837, being among the first countries to develop a network. With the primary goal of transporting sugarcane and refined sugar. Morón's history dates back to 1915 when Colonel José Manuel Tarrafa purchased the Troca rail line and began to assemble the Ferrocarriles del Norte railway line. Morón was chosen as the headquarters for the railway, and the town grew around the railway's maintenance shops and a large central station. As a result of this railway, Morón became the hub of a network of branch lines and sugar lines, which led to the expansion of sugar plantations and centralized sugar mills that were previously located mainly in the south and central part of Cuba. In the 1960s, a road was constructed through the marshland to the coast, and later in the 1990s, a man-made causeway was extended to Cayo Coco and Cayo Guillermo. This led to the construction of a number of hotels in the area, where many of the workers live in Morón and commute to work in specially provided buses.
José Marti is a national hero. He was one of the guys organizing the war against Spaniards going through a second war against Spaniards. You know, he was killed in battle. So in the middle of the Portuguese Indian country of him. So that was that building, the yellow one. So that's the only one with the telecommunication we have in Morón. I mean, in Cuba we have just one, and that's it.
The lack of major company brands in Cuba is largely due to the country's socialist economic system and the US embargo. The Cuban government heavily regulates and restricts foreign investment, making it difficult for foreign companies to operate in the country. Additionally, the U.S. embargo has made it nearly impossible for American companies to do business in Cuba. This combination of factors has made it challenging for major company brands to establish a presence in Cuba, resulting in a limited market for consumer goods and services. Galerias Pauyet, situated in the bustling center of Morón City, offers a unique opportunity to peruse genuine and artistic handmade Cuban statues and souvenirs.
The only one place in Cuba where they have this kind of business is right here. You know, they even export it to different places, you know, all over the world. So in 2004, they won the first award, you know, in New York. You realize everything here is made with full knives, you know, everything is done with that. Even the jewels, everything. You know, here you can buy whatever you want, you know.
Let's take a better look and see what this place has to offer. Galerias Pauyet theme of work consists of making small format sculptures, using cutlery, spoons, forks and kitchen utensils, as the only raw material. They also develop an innovative line of jewelry and goldsmithing in which they use black coral and abalone shell as predominant materials. We'll explore the fascinating history of the Colonel Simón Reyes Hernández Provincial Museum, which is considered the top municipal museum in Cuba.
Simón Reyes Hernández.
The museum was established in March 1983 and is housed in a stunning mustard yellow building with a typical Avilian porch, reflecting the colonial construction style of the 19th century. Interestingly, this building was initially constructed as a command center for the Spanish army, and later served as the electoral board seat during the neocolonial republic. In 1960, it was transformed into the barracks of the revolutionary militia, where troops left for the fight in the Escambray. The museum boasts incredible exhibitions, including a scale model of La Troca, information about Afro-Cuban culture and religion, and a rich collection of traditional festivals of Ciego de Avila. The museum's five permanent exhibition rooms are divided into themes of archaeology, colony, republic, achievements of the revolution, and religious syncretism. For lunch, I'll be showcasing an upscale restaurant and bar situated in the heart of downtown, overlooking Parque Marti. This exclusive establishment boasts a refined atmosphere, featuring live music and serving exquisite cuisine in a comfortable and glamorous setting. Don Avila offers something for everyone, with a variety of spaces to cater to different preferences and budgets, and takes pride in preparing the most delectable international dishes. House's specialty: brocada mixta, beef, pork, chicken, grilled vegetables. Sided with bread and butter, vegetable salad, rice, root vegetables, dessert and a beverage. If you are walking in the city of Morón in Cuba, here are a few things you might see. Parque Marti, a central park, is a great place to relax and people watch. It features a large statue of José Marti, a Cuban national hero. Moron Theater, a beautifully restored theater, is an architectural gem and is still used for performances today. Iglesia de San Juan Bautista, an 18th-century church, is a fine example of colonial architecture and features ornate decorations and religious artwork. Calle Marti is a street which is one of the main commercial areas in Moron and is lined with shops, cafes, and restaurants. Plaza de la Independencia is a square is located in the heart of Moron and features a large monument commemorating Cuba's independence from Spain. These are just a few examples of the many things you might see while walking around the city of Moron in Cuba. The Hotel Encanto, La Rueda, is operated by the Cubanican S.A. Hotel Group. Its restored building in the ecliptic style dating back to 1920. Renowned for its elegant and comfortable atmosphere. The hotel's architecture is of recognized heritage value and is complemented by personalized service. It is a conventional 4-star urban hotel that offers spacious and comfortable rooms suitable for both business and leisure trips.